It has already happened to me to make a long thread and to see the die stop in the middle because it didn't start straight. In this case, the main problem is to start in axis at the beginning of the thread and then remain in axis, otherwise at some point the die will stop and the thread will be made off axis. To solve the problem, I looked at the project by other hole and I modified it a bit. I noticed the construction quality while I was redesigning it. I worked the central support from solid, obtaining the seat for the die. Too precise at the beginning, but then I adjust the shot. The central support has two shoulders because one is used to insert the guide bushes. And to measure the machine diameter, I use a 20mm bar to check where I was, and it was perfect. To help me to be precise, I took advantage of the bed stop, to be sure I didn't go beyond the bushes measurement. At that point, only the internal chamfer remained, and the tool was perfect for this case, having a slightly smaller diameter. A good result, considering the difficulty of making an internal chamfer like that. To be honest, just shooting with camera from that position, yes, really, not easy, but I want to show as much as possible. I would certainly have checked the depth, which according to the drawing should have been 18mm, and in fact it was the requested measure. The late work on the center super was finished. My milling machine was ready for a long but not tedious job, removing 11mm on each side to create space for chip discharge. For this reason, I lowered the head to find the maximum stiffness, and each step was 0.3mm, arriving not at the end, but before the final measurement, so as to finish the measurement only when the depth was reached. Verifying the depth was an iron hole on iron hole, in the sense that small but fantastic depth gauge is another old project. In fact, it hollow measurement under the head of the milling machine, where a normal gauge would not hollow it. I had finally arrived at the end of the first side and the pocket appeared as per the drawing, whose function is to allow the chips to be discharged during the threading phase. Certainly, the conception of a structure like this appears to be not trivial. I was really surprised at how functional it is. I then repeat the same process on the opposite side, and with my gauge I positioned the face parallel to the vise. Another 30 minutes of milling machine and the second pocket was done. Of course, after finishing the two stops, the thread holes for the holding screw are missing. Don't worry, by turning the piece it was easy to create 4 and 5 holes to hold the die. The only way to make this device work is to apply two handles. For this, 2 and 8 holes were made with 10mm counterbore, so the handle would rest on the plane and not on the sternal round surface. The little trick is very useful for making a made stiff. I have seen it done, so I decide to modify the design and apply it here. To be sure that all the threads of the handles abutted, I added a small relief at the end of the thread. By screwing the central support, this stopped perfectly, so the thread was constructed in the most correct way possible. The original design didn't provide knurling, but I love it, and I couldn't resist the temptation. I was nearing the end, and sooner or later I would have to build the bushes. I enjoyed building 3 for M10 and 8 and M6. During the construction, I added this chamfer before cutting off with my parting tool, so as not to repeat the bushing in the chuck one more time. To save material, I used the tailstock DIO in order to make the hole right where I would have cut with the parting tool. In a difficult moment like this, in other words, every little saving is important. My bushing and my handles were finally ready. Only one small job deserves to be done, and it is to make the tip discharge square. My files provide once again to be perfect for the task. Certainly not a fast operation, because it is steel and not iron, and therefore more demanding. Before the final assembly, I thought about how to show the bushing. And then I remembered to have a burnish perfect for the occasion, the blue, to protect the details and make them more visible. Insection is accurate with all surfaces in contact. It will be interesting to test with a long thread and see where the tips end up. I also imagine that the same chips keep the bushing pushing in its position. Or really, it's always a challenge until the end. Collected all the necessary details, I start the assembly. I was really curious to see how the parts fit together. I didn't find it difficult, but the tolerances were certainly a bit narrow in my opinion. But as we say, there is always time to widen. In particular, the insertion of the bushing is not immediate, but not even 1 hour. In one few seconds, the bushing is in place, and its function will certainly avoid having to redo the long screw several times because you did not start straight. For the test, I prepare a bar turned to 7.8 mm, the nominal diameter for an M8 thread. I decide for this one because it is in the middle of the M6 and the M10 in size, but it works well for the others too. The sensation is different from the normal die holder. While processing with the threading, it is if the hand had sensitivity even further forward than the threading, and this is certainly thanks to the bushing. You can appreciate the great final result. I'm really happy to be able to do long threads now without the danger of going wrong. A super new addition to my workshop. And so, as always, thanks for watching and see you next time. AB Shop.